Hi, Dominica here from easysewingforbeginners.com. I've done it. I finally finished making the video for how to make sock monkeys. Aren't they cute? Now the video is a little bit of an epic one. It goes for over an hour, but I've included all the little tips and tricks that you'll need along the way. It'll probably take you a few hours to make a sock monkey. So if you need to take a break at all throughout the video, I'll put a whole heap of links in the description box to different parts of the video, depending on where you're at. Don't forget to email me if you've made one of these little cuties so I can see it, or just leave a comment below to tell me how you've gone. Now, if you make it all the way to the end of this video, I will show you what I have planned for this little sock monkey in the bag here. Okay, happy sock monkey making. Okay, so here I have my pair of socks that I'll be making my sock monkey with. I've already turned them inside out, and on one of them I've just made sure that the heel is centered, and I gave them a press with the warm iron as well. Okay, so I'm just going to push this one to the side because we don't need that one for now. So this is a sock that we'll be using to form the body and the legs of the sock monkey. So first thing we'll need to do is mark some lines for our cutting line and for our sewing lines. So you just need a marker of some sort, whether that's chalk or a texter, whatever you find easiest to mark the socks with. I find the tailor's chalk the easiest. And I've got my ruler. So first thing I'm going to do is mark a line down the middle of the sock here. Okay, and this will be our cutting line. So I'm going to mark probably about an inch from the heel there. So just find the center and just put a little mark there. And then down the bottom as well. Okay. And I'm going to rule my line down. Now I find when I'm ruling on the socks, I find it easier to put a lot of pressure down on the ruler, and that will stop the sock from moving when you're trying to rule your lines. Okay. Okay, so there's our line that we'll need to cut along. Now the next line we'll need to do is the line that we're going to be sewing along. So we're going to mark about a quarter of an inch away from that middle line. Okay, so probably about level from the top of the other line that you ruled. And it doesn't need to be perfect, it's just a guide for you. And when you get to the bottom here, I'm just going to use the chalk to draw a bit of a curve for the bottom of the foot. Okay. Again, it doesn't need to be perfect, it's just a guide for you to go along. When you've made about 20 million of these sock monkeys, you won't even need to rule these lines. Okay, and just another line on the other side of that middle line, about a quarter of an inch away. I'm just going to guesstimate that. Okay, and the same again. Just draw the curve on there. Okay, be careful not to go too close to the end, especially if the bottom layer of the sock isn't quite at the same point as the top layer of the sock. Okay. Now the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to pin a little piece of tear-away stabilizer onto the back of my sock. Now this isn't essential, but I found I had to do it with my sewing machine only because the socks would get caught on the feed dogs, and that would stop the machine from being able to feed the socks through. So just end up with a big ball of thread on the sock. Okay,
So I've cut a small piece just to go under where I'm sewing. Okay, and I'm just going to use a couple of pins just to pin that in place while I'm sewing. Okay, so now we're ready to take this over to the sewing machine. Okay, so now we're ready to sew the first two legs of our sock monkey. I've got my sewing machine set up with my walking foot, and this will help the top layer of the sock move through at a similar rate to the bottom layer of the sock. I've put a darker thread in my sewing machine just so you can see it easily, but usually match the thread up with the sock as best you can. I'm going to be using a triple stitch on my sewing machine. Now, I highly recommend using the triple stitch only because it will give your sock extra strength, especially if it's being pulled by little children. So I've just got this here to show you. Just as an example, this line here was sewn just using the standard straight stitch. And as soon as it's pulled, it snaps really easily. Okay, I find the first one that I made it using just a normal stitch, and I'm forever sewing up holes with it. So this is the triple stitch here, okay, and it's perfect for a really stretchy fabric. Okay, you can see you can pull it. Even when I pull it as much as I can, it still doesn't snap. So if you have that on your machine, I highly recommend it. And it looks like three dashed lines together. So most sewing machines should have it. Okay, let's get ready to sew. All right, I'm going to start sewing the left leg first. So I'm going to position the sock with my first blue line on the left there under the foot and just lined up with the middle of the presser foot there. Okay, I'm going to lower my presser foot. I'm going to put my needle in the down position. Okay, and I'm just going to do a locking stitch just to secure that thread in place there. Okay, and off I go. Now you might find that the top layer of fabric might not move through as well as the bottom layer, even with the walking foot. So every now and then you might just need to lift the presser foot up, making sure that needle is still down, and just move that fabric at the top there through a little bit. Keep going. Okay, and when you get to the end, you might just want to just try and encourage the sock to turn, and you might need to lift the presser foot up, making sure the needle's still down, and just turn the sock a little bit and do a couple of stitches, and then just turn a little bit more just to create that curve at the bottom of the foot there. When you get to the side at the end there, let's do another locking stitch. Okay, needle up. There you go. And you just need to repeat that process with the other leg. Okay, so now that we've sewn both of the seam lines for the legs, we need to cut the legs apart up the middle here and just trim around the curves. Before we do that though, we just need to remove these pins. And if you've used the tear-away stabilizer like I have, you need to rip that away first. So I never get this right the first time, but just if you can, just try and tear it as close as you can to the seam as possible. Same on the other side. Okay. So now I'm going to cut along that center line that we ruled at the beginning there, being careful not to cut through the sewn lines. And then I'm just going to cut probably about an extra 3/4 of an inch past the end of those sewn lines. Okay, and this will just create a bigger opening for when we turn and stuff the sock monkey. And then the last bit here, you just need to trim around the curves at the bottom of the feet there. This one as well. Okay. Now we're ready to turn and stuff the sock monkey. Okay, so now we're ready to turn and stuff the body of the sock monkey. So you can do this part by hand, and it just takes a bit of patience and time. But something that I've come across and I use all the time now when I'm turning and stuffing softies or tubes of fabric is this turning and stuffing tool. Okay, so I'll show you how it works, and it just makes the job so much easier. And it also stops the opening from becoming too frayed. So what you need to do, just going to open up the opening there. I'm going to put the tube inside one of the legs and pull the leg all the way down. And then with this stuffing tool, there's an end with a fork and just a curved end. So use the curved end to just poke gently into the tip of the tube. And then you just pull the fabric over the stick, just gently, like that. And then I just usually at this stage use a stick to poke the tips out and make sure it's nice and rounded. And then once you've got that bit out, you can just pull the rest all the way through. Okay, and you just need to do the same with the other leg. So you put the tube in. Okay. Pull the leg all the way over the tube. Put the stick in the top of the tube there. And then just pull the fabric over the top there. Oops. Just make sure the toe's all the way out nicely. Okay. And you can do the same with the body as well if you like, or you can just pull that bit through by hand. Okay, so now the sock monkey's turned right side out. So we're going to use this same tool to stuff the sock monkey. So again, you can do it by hand, or some people like to use a pencil or a chopstick, or a paintbrush with short bristles. That can usually work to stuff the softy or sock monkey. But with this stuffing tool, you do the same thing. Put the tube down, and I like to go all the way down to the bottom of the leg there, and just grabbing a little bit of your stuffing at a time. This is toy filling or hobby fill that I've just got from the local sewing shop. Okay, and then you use the fork end of the stuffing tool to push it down. Okay, and then you just keep repeating that, grabbing little bits at a time and stuffing them in. Okay, and what you might need to do is just work the stuffing around a bit. You might need to roll it in between your hands, just so it doesn't come out all lumpy. Okay. So I'm going to keep on stuffing my sock monkey. Once I finish this leg, I'll do the other leg and the body, and then we'll come back and I'll show you how I like to stitch up this opening. Now, I just wanted to show you quickly what I do when I'm stuffing the body of the sock monkey. Now, I use a bigger ball of the stuffing and just get it all in there. And then you'll find it will come out quite lumpy. So to give your sock monkey a nice shape, I just use the stuffing tool just to move that stuffing around on the inside and just use my hands around the outside just to shape it nicely. Okay. So again. Just got the stuffing in there. Use that stuffing tool to move it around to where you want it to go. Okay, so we've finished stuffing the legs and the body of the sock monkey. So now we need to close up this opening. Now I've got a particular way that I like to do it just to give it that extra strength that it needs and to give it a nice look when it's done as well. Okay, so I've threaded my needle and I've doubled the thread over and I've done a nice big knot at the end there. Okay, now I'm left-handed, so I'll be working mostly left to right. So if you're right-handed, you'll just need to flip that and you'll be working from right to left. Okay, so to get started, what I'm going to do is just inside the sock monkey, I'm just going to secure this thread. Okay, and just when the thread gets to the end there, I'm just going to put the needle through the end loop there. Okay, and that will really secure it in place. And just hide that knot away in there. Okay, now the first thing that I like to do once I've secured the thread is I'm going to do a running stitch all the way around the opening here, about just under a quarter of an inch away from the edge. Okay, and basically what this does is it gives us a guide for us to do our ladder stitch along, which I'll show you how to do after when we're sewing the opening closed. Okay, so remember I'm starting from the left and we're going right, so if you're right-handed you'll just need to go from right to left. Okay, so it doesn't need to be absolutely perfect. So your running stitch is going to look a little bit like that. And just keep going all the way around. Okay, so we've done that running stitch. Let's put it in a spot where you can see a bit better. All the way around. Now if you pull it just gently, it should bring those two edges in a little bit. Okay, you don't want to pull it too hard. Okay. Alright, so the next thing we're going to do is we're going to do our ladder stitch to close this opening up. Alright, so I'll just try and get the sock in a place where it's easy for you to see. Okay, so here's the beginning of my thread. Here's my running stitch that I've done. So I'm going to use these lines as a guide for me to go along to make sure that I have that quarter inch seam on the inside of the opening. Okay, so to do our ladder stitch, we're going to start by going through one side of the sock monkey and probably about a quarter inch or just under a quarter of an inch. Okay, and then directly across, might have to hold the edges together a little bit here. We're going to go through to the inside of the sock monkey and out about a quarter of an inch. Okay. Now I'm not going to pull this closed just yet, just so you can see why it's called a ladder stitch. Make sure you only grab one layer of the sock monkey there. Okay, you can see as I'm going, it kind of looks like the rungs on a ladder. Okay, and this is a bit of a magical stitch as well. I'll show you why in a moment. Okay. All right, I'm going to do one more. Okay, so now if I pull this stitch, you see it will bring those edges together and it should close it up so you can hardly see the thread that you used at all. Now I used a contrasting thread so you can probably see it a little bit, but if you used a thread that's a similar color to your sock monkey, then you'll hardly be able to see it at all. Now you'll find once you've closed it up, you'll probably end up with a little bit of an empty spot here. So what I'm going to do before I do any more, I'm just going to get my stuffing stick. Now this is the skinnier version of the stuffing stick. Just put it in like that. Get a bit of stuffing. And I'm going to try and fill that hole in there. Just move that stuffing around a little bit. Just do a little bit more to fill in that gap there. Okay, so now that's filled in that spot there nicely. Alright, so back to my ladder stitch. Doesn't matter if it comes undone a little bit, you can just pull it, do a few more stitches and then pull them together. So remember to use that running stitch as a guide for your quarter inch seam allowance. Now I find it's easiest to do the ladder stitch if I've got my softy or sock monkey or whatever I'm doing flat on the table. Okay, so I finished my ladder stitch and I also went back the other way just to give it a little bit of extra strength. So now we need to finish off this ladder stitch. So what I like to do is just try and grab a stitch in the seam there, or if not, just a few bits of thread from the seam. Okay, and just pull your thread through, and then before you pull it all the way through, see how you're left with a little loop there? I'm just going to put my needle through that loop and then pull it tight, just to really secure that thread in place. And I'm going to go through just one more time. I like to make sure things are nice and secure and strong because I really don't like having to re-sew things once I've done them. Okay, so now you're left with a knot on the outside there. So what I like to do is just put your needle through the seam and then bring it out somewhere in the softy, and then just pull gently and that will pull the knot and hide it in the seam there, okay, so you can't see it at all. And just snip off that thread and that'll disappear inside there, okay. So now the opening's all closed and nice and strong, and we're ready to move on to the next step. Okay, so now you need the other sock to form the tail, arms, ears, and mouth of your sock monkey. Alright, so you'll need your ruler and your tailor's chalk or whatever you're drawing on your sock monkey with. I just dropped mine, so I'm using a piece of my tailor's chalk. Now, you'll find in the PDF that I made for this project, there is a layout suggestion of where you can put the tail, the arms, the ears, and the mouth. So you can download that, print it off, and use that as a guide as well. Alright, so I'm going to start by putting the tail along this edge of the sock. So hopefully my chalk's going to work for me. So I'm just going to guesstimate really about how wide I want the tail to be. So I definitely want it to be a little bit skinnier than the arms. All right, so I'm going to draw my line. Okay, and like we did with the legs, we're just going to draw that curve on there. Okay, doesn't need to be perfect, it's just a guide. And then depending on how long you want your tail to be, you can keep on going up a little bit. Just follow that curve along. I'll probably go to about there. Okay. Alright, so now we're going to rule our lines for our arms of the sock monkey. Now what I'm going to do is I'm just going to leave about a quarter of an inch in between my blue lines. The blue lines are the lines I'm going to sew along, except for this one up here. But I need to have enough space in between so I can cut cut through after I've sewn them. Okay, so going to rule one line there. Oops. Okay, and then I'm just going to measure. I have about 2 inches there to play with, and I need to leave another quarter of an inch in between the arms to cut. So I'm probably going to rule my line probably about here, I reckon. That would be the other side of my arm, of one arm. Okay, and then just a little gap. That's the other side of my arm. Okay, and then just draw your curves in for the bottom of the arms. So for this arm, it's just going to have one sewn line, and the other side of the arm will just be the edge of the sock. This arm in the middle will have two sewn lines. It won't really make that much of a difference. You won't notice it too much. Okay, and here's your tail. Now we're going to trace the ears on. I've done up a bit of a template for the ears. You can just draw your own ears on if you want to, or you can use this template. I traced my template onto a bit of interfacing, I think, some see-through interfacing, just a little bit of a thick interfacing. I find it's easier to create my templates like that. You can use tracing paper if you like, or baking paper even, if you've got some of that in the drawer. Okay, just to give you something to draw as a guide to draw your lines around. Okay, so I'm going to do my ears on this part of the sock here. So just hold your ear in place while you draw, trace around the ear. Okay, so there's one, and do that. So I'm going to do the other one next to it there. Okay. So now what I'm going to do, so I'm going to put a couple of pins in the sock just to stop it from, stop the layers from shifting around. But like before, I'm going to put the tear-away stabilizer onto the back of it, onto the back of the sock, like so. Just grab a couple of pins. And I'm just going to put a couple in just to secure it in place and just hold everything together. Might put that one in there. Okay, so we're ready to take this one over to the sewing machine now to sew. Okay, so just like I did when I sewed the legs for the other sock, I've got my machine on triple stitch. And got my walking foot on. I'm just going to start with the tail. I'm going to start at the top. I don't know why I drew that line across the top there, but just ignore that. I'm not going to sew along that line. Okay, I'm going to put my needle in the down position and just do a locking stitch at the top there just to secure it a little bit more. Okay, and then off I go. Okay, so now I've sewn the tail, so you just need to repeat that with the arms, and then the same thing when you're doing the ears, start on one end and then go around the curve, and if you need to, make sure the needle's down, lift the presser foot up and just turn if that curve's too sharp for you. Okay. Okay, so I finished sewing all the limbs and the ears. The sock monkey. I snipped off my threads, tore off the stabilizer on the back, and now I'm ready to cut out the limbs. Okay, so pretty similar to what we did when we were cutting the leg of the sock monkey. So very carefully cut in between those two seams there. And at the top here, snip along, and like before, just trim around the bottom, just being careful not to cut through your seam. Okay, and you just need to repeat that with your arms as well. So with the ears, same thing, just cut them out. And then cut along the end there. And that will give you your opening to turn your ears the right side out. Now, I'm going to leave the other ones to do after, but I'm going to show you how I cut out the mouth. I used the toe of the sock for the mouth, okay, and I actually used the seam line along the toe as a guide from when I'm doing the mouth on the sock monkey, and I'll show you how I do that a bit later on. But when I'm cutting it out, I just make sure that the two ends of the toe seam are about the same on either side of the sock. Okay, and then I'll cut around. So if you imagine that's going to be the mouth on your sock monkey, you want to have a little bit of space underneath for when you sew your mouth onto the sock monkey, and just to bring the mouth line up a little bit. So if that doesn't make sense, it all makes sense when I show you afterwards. But just make sure when you're cutting, give it a little bit of space at the bottom. Okay. All right. So then when you turn it right side out, there's a fluff on there. Okay. That will be the line there for the mouth. Okay. And it'll go on the sock monkey like that. Okay. So I'm just going to go and cut out the other pieces of the sock monkey from that sock, and then we'll be ready for the next step. Okay, so I've cut all the limbs and the other body parts out. So now we're ready to turn these the right side out. So I've got the ears, they're pretty easy. You can just turn them out by hand. They've got a large opening. Just make sure get those seams right out. Okay. So with the tail and the arms, I'm just going to use the turning and stuffing tool again. So you can do it by hand. I'm going to use this tool. So stick the tube in. It's good with the socks because they're super stretchy. And just get the stick from the stuffing tool. Put it in the top of the tube. I usually try and get a seam going through the tube. It makes it easier. And then just slide the rest of the sock over. Oops, take the tube off. And before you take the stick out, just use it to get in there to make sure the ends are turned out nicely. And then you can pull the rest of the tail through. And just repeat the same thing with the arms. Okay. So I'm going to finish turning these ones, and then we'll be ready to stuff the tail and the arms. Okay, so just like we did with the body and the legs, we're going to use the stuffing tool and some stuffing to stuff the tail and the arms of our sock monkey. Okay, so like before, going to put the tail onto the tube all the way down to the end, and then just grabbing little bits of stuffing at a time, stuff it into the tube. And as you slowly start to feel the tail out, you can pull the tail off the tube a bit. Okay, so it starts to form the tail. And you just keep repeating this until you get to the end of the tail. And do exactly the same thing with the arms. Okay, so now I'm getting ready to do the face of the sock monkey. So what I've got here is a little template for the eyes and the mouth of the sock monkey. Now, it might not look like it makes sense at the moment, but what's going to happen is once it's on the sock monkey, we're going to use this bit here as a guide for where to put our mouth onto. So we'll go around like that. Okay, so just to make it easy for you. Okay, so I've traced my template onto my interfacing or stabilizer. Okay, just going to put it onto some white felt. Okay, and I've just got a chalk pencil to trace around the template with. Okay. Okay, so you can kind of see the outline there. Okay, so I'm going to cut that out. Okay, and what I've also done as well is I had some black felt which I'd used to cut some eyes from. Okay, now I've chosen to use felt mainly because I make my sock monkeys for little children, so it just makes it really safe rather than using buttons, but there's no reason why you can't use your felt for the template and then sew some buttons on there. Okay, so I'm going to go and cut this piece out and then I'll show you how I put it together and attach it to the face, to the body of the monkey. Okay, so the next thing I'm going to do is sew the eyes onto the face piece. Okay, so I'm going to do is just position it in place. Just thing I like it about there. And I've threaded my needle and doubled the thread over and done a nice big knot on the end there. So what we're going to do, we're going to sew this eye in place just using a running stitch. Okay, so from behind, bring the needle up through and probably about probably an eighth of an inch from the edge of the eye. Okay, and we're going to take the needle back through. Okay, and pretty much doing a running stitch. I'm using a black thread, so it's not so obvious. And just use a thread. Okay, when you get back to the beginning, just turn it over. And I'm just going to secure it in place, just put it through some of the felt at the back there. Once you've got a little loop, put your needle through the loop and pull it tight. And then just do that one more time. Okay. And I'll just snip that thread off now. So you'd repeat that with the other eye, okay? And remember, if you chose to sew buttons on, you can sew the buttons on now instead of the felt. Okay? Okay, so now that we've finished sewing the eyes onto the face piece, we're going to sew this face piece onto the body of the sock monkey. So I'm going to position it probably just under the heel line there and in the center of the body. Okay, and I'm just going to put a pin in the middle there just to hold it in place for now. Now I'm going to sew this face piece on using two strands of embroidery thread. Okay, so I've put two strands through my needle and I've doubled it over. And I've just knotted it at the end there. Okay, so sometimes I just do white thread around the face piece so you can't see it, and other times I'll use a contrasting colour so it stands out. So to get started, I put the thread in from behind the face piece and pull it through. And just going to use a running stitch to stitch this face piece on. Now I usually start at the bottom because this will give me a bit of an opportunity to practice my running stitch to make sure it looks okay. So you probably want to have about a quarter of an inch, just under a quarter of an inch gap between your running stitches. And it doesn't really matter if it's a bit wonky, it gives the sock monkey just a little bit of extra character. Okay, so I'm just going to finish this running stitch off by securing it in place here. Now, it doesn't matter if you do this at the top, because this bit down here will be underneath the mouthpiece anyway, so you won't see it. Okay, there we have it. We've sewn on the face piece with a running stitch. And the next thing we're going to do is get ready to sew on the mouthpiece. Okay, so now we're going to get this mouthpiece ready to sew onto the body. So at the moment we've got these edges that are rolling upwards, but what we're going to do is we're going to use a basting stitch to hold them inside the mouthpiece, and then that way that will give us a nice clean edge to sew onto our body piece. Okay, so to do the basting stitch, I've just put some thread onto a needle. I'm going to roll the edge of the face piece under probably about a quarter of an inch, maybe a little bit more. Okay, and I'm just going to do, it's just like a running stitch. Try not to do it too close to the edge. I'm just going to leave a bit of a tail there. Okay. So this basting stitch is just temporary. And once I've sewn this mouthpiece onto the body, I'll remove it. Okay, so that's the basting stitch done. I'm going to snip the end of that thread off. Don't need that one anymore. Okay, now I'm going to get ready to sew this mouthpiece onto the body. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to place it over the spot where I'm going to sew. So this is where it's going to go over. Okay, make sure those pieces there are turned under. And then I'm just going to use a couple of pins to pin it in place. Okay, so I've made sure the seam of the toe is underneath there, because that's what I'll be stitching along to do the mouth later. So now I've got my thread that I'm going to sew the mouthpiece onto. I've doubled the thread over and I've put a knot at the end of it. Okay, so just like we did when we were closing up the opening for the legs, I'm going to use a ladder stitch to attach the mouthpiece onto the body. Okay, I'm going to come up just from behind and underneath and I'm going to put the thread through once, and then I'm going to put it through one more time just to secure that thread in place there. So once you've got your little loop, put your needle through the loop and then pull it tight there to secure it in. Okay, so just like we did with the other one, I'm going to start on the mouthpiece here. Now remember, I'm left-handed, so I'm going to be going from left to right. If you're right-handed, you'll work from right to left. Okay, so put it through probably about just under a quarter of an inch, I think. Okay, and then directly across, but on the body piece now, put the thread, put the needle through, like that. Okay, and then back through the mouthpiece. Okay, we're doing our ladder stitch. Now for the mouthpiece, I'd usually just go around once. I don't think it will have much of a chance of getting pulled and coming unstitched very easily. Okay, every now and then, just give it a gentle pull. Keep on going. Okay, so I've done my ladder stitch nearly all the way around the mouth of the monkey, and now I've left a little bit of a gap there because I'll need to put some stuffing into that mouth to fill it out a bit. So you can either do it by hand. I'm going to use my little stuffing tool again. So just poke it in there gently and then just trying to put the monkey this way so you can see. Alright, I'm going to add the stuffing in. And just move it around just to get the shape that I'm after. Okay, that's better. Alright, so now I'm going to finish closing up the rest of this opening here. Okay, when you get to the end, like we did with the other ones, just pick up a thread or two from your seam line there. And once you've got the loop at the end, put your needle through the loop and secure it in place. And then I'm just going to do that one more time. Okay, and then put the needle up through the seam and out through a different spot. And just gently give it a bit of a pull to pull that knot through and then snip it off. Okay, so sewn on the mouthpiece, and then you can just go through and just do a few snips and remove that basting stitch there. Okay, and then we'll be ready for the next step. Okay, so now we're ready to sew the mouth onto the sock monkey. So I've just got my needle ready with two threads of embroidery thread, and I've doubled it over and knotted it at the end there. Okay, so what I like to do is just see if you can get it through the gap in your ladder stitch here. Okay, and I just like to put the needle out through where the seam on the sock line is, and just see if you can pull that knot through. Okay, usually if you get it right in between, and it should go through nicely. Okay, so I'm going to sew the mouth using a back stitch, and I've got the seam line of the toe going along there. So I'm going to use that line as a guide for my mouth. Okay, so do a back stitch. So I'm going to go behind about a quarter of an inch where the thread is coming out, and then in front by about a quarter of an inch. Okay, I'm going to pull it through, look like that, and then I'm going to put my needle back in just where the other stitch ends, trying to line it up as best I can. Okay, and just repeat that process all the way along that seam line there. Just one more stitch to go. So for the last one, I'm just going to put it in and just come back out at the thread there. Okay. And to finish it off, I'm just going to grab a bit of a thread from the sock and do a knot. Okay, and then I'm going to stick the needle through the sock and back out at a different point and just pull that knot through. Okay, and that will hide it away nicely there. Cut that thread off. And there we have it. Monkey now has a nice smile, and if you wanted to, you could probably even use that thread to do a couple of nostrils as well. I usually just leave it. Okay, let's move on to the next step. Okay, so for this step we're going to sew on the ears. So I've got our ear that's been turned right side out. So we want to get rid of that raw edge. I'm going to tuck it in, probably about a quarter of an inch again. Okay. And then what I'm going to do is I've got my needle and I've just got my thread doubled over. So I'm going to stick my thread in and hide that. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to do a whip stitch just to hold the opening of that ear closed and hide that raw edge away. Okay, so go through one side and come back out on the other side. Alright, now what I'm going to do is I'm going to bring these two ends of the ear together. Okay, and then just do a couple of whip stitches just to hold them together. Okay, so you'll end up with something that looks a bit like this. Alright, now we need to attach it onto the side of the body. Now, when I put the ears on, I usually like to put them on probably about level with the eyes, okay?
So you can really choose where you want to put them. You can put them a bit higher, you can put them a bit lower if you want. It's really up to you. Okay, and now what I'm going to do, once you've got it in place, this is a tricky bit. Might want to just place a pin in there just to hold it in place while you get the stitching started. And just like all the other pieces that I've sewn on, I'm going to use a ladder stitch. Okay, so again, sewing into the body of the sock monkey. A bit hard for you to see there. And then I'm going to stitch a little bit into the ear. Okay. Again. And with the ears, you probably only need to go around once for these. Secured on nicely there. Okay, we're almost there. I've got the ears sewn on now. Okay, so what we've got left now is the arms and the tail. Okay, so I'm going to start off with one of the arms. Now I've got my thread doubled over and a knot in the end. What I'm going to do first is I'm going to do a running stitch all the way around the top edge of the arm. Okay. All right. And I'm going to pull this in to gather up all those raw edges, and I'm going to try and push those raw edges in as best I can, and then pull it again. Okay, so now I've kind of tucked away those raw edges, and that will help give us a neater finish at the end as well. Okay, so to sew the arm on, I usually position the arm probably just in line with, just below the mouth, I think. Okay, really you can choose where you want to put them. Alright, so then what I do, I'm going to just turn it upside down. I'm going to start the stitching so it's from the underside of the arm here. Okay, and the same as I've done with everything else, we're going to sew it on using the ladder stitch. Okay, might be a bit hard for you to see, it might be a bit easier. Okay, so a bit through the body and then through the arm. Okay, now I highly recommend going around the arms and the tail parts twice, mainly because these will be pulled a lot, especially if they're being given to young children, and you want them to be as secure as possible. You don't want them falling off, getting pulled off. Okay, so I'm going to stitch, ladder stitch around the arms twice. And I'm going to do the same with the tail, except the tail is going to be on the back side there. So you can choose whether you put it up a little bit or whether you put it right on the bottom there. Okay, I'm going to finish sewing on the arms and the tail, and then we are done. Okay, so the arms and the tail have now been sewn onto the sock monkey, and it's all finished. Isn't it cute? Just love them.
Wow, well done for making it all the way to the end of this video. I hope you've enjoyed making the sock monkeys. Now to the mystery of the monkey in the bag. This monkey is going to be dropped or left somewhere in the hope that someone finds it and adopts it, gives it a good home. Okay, so this is part of a movement from the Secret Toy Society. I'll put a link in the description box if you want to read more about it. But basically, it's about people making handmade toys and leaving them in random spots so someone can find them and just create a little bit of happiness for them. Really, that's what it's about. So I'm looking forward to leaving it somewhere. I felt a bit bad putting the monkey in the bag, but hopefully it gets found pretty quickly. Okay, so I hope you've enjoyed watching this video. I hope you've learned something from it. Hit the thumbs up button if you found the video useful. Share the video with your friends if you think they'll enjoy making a sock monkey. And don't forget to leave a comment or email me to let me know how you've gone as well. Happy sewing, and I'll see you next time. See ya.